Hey everyone, this is Alan again. This is youtube.com/speedracer1976. Glad to have you all here with me. Man, it's been a crazy week. But first I want to start out with, just yesterday, we actually crowned the new Mr. Chicago Leather, Miguel Torres. Congratulations, bud. You've got a great year ahead of you. Wish I could have been there. Unfortunately, work actually has me down in Orlando, Florida this week, which is where I'm broadcasting from today. Woohoo! This past week, we had two major all-hands calls that we had to work with. And then I moved my desk to my, I moved everything to my new desk upstairs. And then I flew down here to sunny Orlando, Florida. Man, I hear it's going to be cold back in Nebraska again. Nah, you know, hey, I'm down here. I can't wait for it. All right. Speaking of Orlando, I flew down here Friday evening. Got in really, really late. Got in like 10:30 Friday evening. I decided I was going to try to experience a little bit of local flavor, do a little something different. And so I actually booked for my first two nights, which were on my dime. I booked at the Parliament House here in Orlando. Now, mind you, the bars are great. The bars are great. The staff is great. The hotel was just not what I was looking for. The hotel, the room that I was in was obviously a smoking room. It reeked of smoke, and I'm not a smoker, so that kind of killed it for me. And then there was just a whole lot of other things, and really, I just did not feel comfortable there. So last night, I actually checked into a different hotel, went to a Clarion here in Orlando. It's close to where I'm at right now, and felt a whole lot better, a whole lot safer. And so Saturday, I had a ticket to go out to the Kennedy Space Center, did their mega tour out there. By the way, for those that don't know, Kennedy Space Center here in Orlando, Florida, is the major spaceport for the United States, which is where all of our manned spacecraft take off from. This has been a dream of mine. I've always wanted to come down here. I wanted to come down and watch a shuttle launch. Unfortunately, that did not occur. But I did come down, and actually right now, one of the space shuttles, the space shuttle Atlantis, is actually set up here, and they have a new exhibit. And if you haven't been, it's so awesome, so worth it. The way that they reveal Atlantis is just mind-blowing. It's awesome. I was just truly humbled and impressed. I've got some great photographs of that. And then I went on the mega tour, which is something that apparently they're going to stop doing here pretty soon. Then basically I went out to the vehicle assembly building, that big large building with the big huge American flag. Apparently the stars on the American flag there are 6 foot across. I'm 6'3". That really kind of brought it home to me. I'm going, man, that's a huge flag. I think all the stripes they said are like 8 feet wide. So wow, that was pretty amazing. I actually got to go in to the vehicle assembly building, and I actually got to see that they're working on the next capsule that they're working on for the manned space program. So that was pretty kind of cool. And that building is just so immensely huge. Pictures couldn't do it justice. It really couldn't. But then we also went out to Launch Pad 39A, which is where the majority of the space shuttle launches took off from. Actually, that's where the majority of manned space launches took off from, is Launch Pad 39A. So that was really, really awesome to get to go out there. We actually got to go inside the security fence, and we got to go pretty close to it. We actually got to go down to the flame trench. We didn't actually go into the flame trench, but we were just outside of it. So that was pretty awesome. If you're ever going to the Kennedy Space Center, I highly recommend, if they have the mega tour available, definitely do it. But I think they're going to stop doing it here pretty soon, because they're going to cut off doing either the vehicle assembly building or the launch pad, because they're going to start getting everything ready for the new next-gen manned spacecraft. It's kind of cool. They had a tour guide that was just awesome. It was phenomenal. It was a great time. Other than that, today I actually went out to SeaWorld and I bought the Quick Queue Pass, which is what you see here. The Quick Queue Pass basically lets you skip all lines, and actually it really worked in my favor. I didn't really at first didn't have a whole lot of lines that I was skipping, but it let me save steps because I could go up a back way. That was kind of cool. But by doing that, I actually got to go on the Manta roller coaster 5 times in the first hour that the park was open. Holy cow, I love that ride. I really, really love that ride. I went over and tried the Kraken as well. I wasn't as impressed with it. Just really didn't trip my trigger a lot. But the Manta was awesome. It was phenomenal. I actually ended up going on it 13 times. A large part of that was because, well, it's really the only roller coaster that I wanted to go on, and I wanted to make it worth my while. But, you know, it also had to do with, they had very friendly staff, and there was actually one cute cub type guy there that I kept on flirting with. And, you know, he and I were just talking off and on the whole time. It was a really great time. So that was my past week. This next week, we got a conference coming up. That's why I'm down here in Orlando. We got a conference coming up. I've got a great hotel room. Again, pictures can't do it justice. I checked in. I was like, I'm floored and I'm humbled. Apparently, I pleased somebody well enough that I got a very, very nice room. Got a national conference going on. You know, I got my play out of the way this past weekend. I'm glad I got to get all my play done. But this next week is going to be a lot of hard work. We're going to have a lot of people. There's going to be a lot of time pressure, time-sensitive crunches of we need to get this thing done, we need to get it done now. As I mentioned last week, we have a lot of people that are coming in speaking. We've got Mitt Romney. I actually do hope I get the chance to meet him, just because I'd like to meet him. We also have quite a few of the contributors, Mara Liasson and Juan Williams from Fox News. You know, I'm not a huge Fox News fan, although I do watch Fox News Sunday, and I watch all the other Sunday morning shows. I like to keep myself pretty well versed and know the different sides of stories. I don't consider myself a liberal. I don't consider myself a conservative. I'm kind of in the middle. I form my own opinions, but I like to listen to both sides and see how both sides address certain things. See what, you know, they say. They cover certain news on Face the Nation. They cover certain news on Fox News Sunday, and some things they don't cover the same. Some, you know, they don't even have the same stories. And then when they do have the same stories, they have different angles, obviously. So it's going to be very fun, but very stressful week. I'm glad I have a very nice, comfortable room to be able to come back to. And I've actually got my teammate flying in tomorrow, so should be a great time. All right, that's all I've got for today. Actually, that's 7 minutes worth, so it's quite a lot. Again, if you like what you hear me talk about, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Leave me comments, please, people. Let me know what you think. If you're liking these, if you're not liking these, if I shouldn't be doing it, let me know what you guys think. All right, that's all I've got for this week from sunny Orlando, Florida. You guys have a great weekend. See you next weekend. Bye.